What if you could turn a ton of information from websites or PDFs into a mind map, interact with it, arrange it, and then drop the results as markdown straight into Obsidian? Well, this is exactly what I'm going to show you today. By the end of this video, you will know exactly how to use ResearchFlow to speed up your research, whether you're diving into scientific topics or trying to master your favorite game or map out your next business strategy. That's exactly what ResearchFlow does. It is not just another AI chatbot. It maps out ideas visually, dives into academic sources, and helps you build real understanding. ResearchFlow turns dense documents into very clear visual maps, like mind maps, and eventually into markdown notes, and it does this instantly. We can search, read, summarize, explore, and question academic papers without losing our flow. And if you use Obsidian, then this tool feels exactly like it was built just for you. We first need to create a free account on their website, the link to which is in the description. After that, we can sign in and see its homepage. Let's get oriented to understand the user interface a bit better. When we open ResearchFlow, we see its homepage. This gives us a chat box where we can ask our question just as we would on platforms like ChatGPT or Claude. But already at this point, we can see some differences. First, we can decide whether the answers shall be based purely on academic papers, on a web search, or just on what the underlying LLM, the large language model, already knows without going online. Second, we can select our preferred language. For me, it's English. Currently, there are no other non-Asian languages, but I expect that those will be added eventually. And third, we can choose the large language model to use. If we are using the free version, we have two options at the moment. For pro users, there are more. If we start with a new board, ResearchFlow takes us straight to the canvas. We can give this flow a title, click on Ask AI, and then ask our question here. As you can see, we have the same options for restricting the results to academic papers, the web, or the model. However, we cannot change the model here. We can also see several quick actions and the I wonder section. We will come back to those a bit later. If we prefer to work with our own files, we can pick the file upload option and add our documents. ResearchFlow will create a canvas with one node, or card as they call it, for each of our files. We can now interact with them. Again, I will demonstrate this later with practical use cases. If we are already on a board, we can click on New Research and get the same options to choose from. While we have a canvas or a mind map open, we can change the citation style. I suppose that's mostly relevant for academic purposes. We can change the language, again, somewhat limited at the moment, change the model. Note that this change would only affect any subsequent interaction and not change already existing cards. We can search for academic papers, which we're going to see during the practical use case demo. And at the bottom of the screen, we can find these three icons. The first one lets us create an empty card with which we can then interact. We can also upload our own files here to be added to this canvas directly. And again, search for academic papers. However we start our research, the results don't just appear as text. They become nodes on a mind map. ResearchFlow calls them cards. Each of those is expandable, editable, and AI assisted. If we click on a card, we can add new cards as a sibling or a child, copy the text from the current card, and if we want to highlight cards, we can use these color codes to do so. For more advanced interactions, we can click on Ask AI. This gives us options to dive in, explain, simplify, or get specific examples for that card's content. We also get a number of suggested questions for the respective topic. We can work just with the canvas or open the research report next to it whenever we need it. And the best part? No linear chats, just infinite open space to organize our thoughts flexibly. And speaking of organizing thoughts in a smarter way, Skillshare has been one of my favorite places to learn how I work and create. Imagine my surprise when they reached out offering to sponsor some videos. I happily agreed, and now Skillshare is the sponsor of today's video. There are many things to like about Skillshare. especially that they have got thousands of classes across a huge variety of topics, from design to video editing and productivity, and pretty much anything in between. One class that helped me is YouTube Success, Script, Shoot, and Edit with MKBHD. Yep, Marques Brown Lee, one of the most successful creators on YouTube, walks us through his entire process. One tip that really stuck with me is that scripting upfront can actually save time in editing. That clicked instantly with how I structure ideas in tools like ResearchFlow or Obsidian. And combined with the other editing tips, I feel like my videos are slowly getting better for you, the viewer. I really hope that's not just my impression. And if you're not into creative topics, but into things like system thinking, digital workflows, or building a second brain, there are plenty of productivity-focused classes too, covering everything from time blocking and creative routines to mastering tools that help you think clearer and move faster. Still not sure if Skillshare is the right thing for you? I got you covered. The first 500 people to use the link in the description get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. With that, you can safely join the largest online learning community for creatives and benefit from their learning by doing approach when submitting your own project and then getting feedback on it. Let's say we are curious about how social media affects political polarization. First, we will search for the phrase social media's influence on political polarization. Initially, we search across the whole web. Pretty quickly, we get a research report, and we can also see a mind map being created in the background. If I make the report a bit smaller, we can see more of that. Before we go to the mind map, let's take a quick look at the report itself. It is nicely structured and includes references to the various data sources. These can be from any website and also include academic sources. Now, let's hide the research report for a moment and focus on the mind map. This is a well-structured visualization of the research report, so they are directly connected. We can easily navigate, zoom in, and interact with the whole mind map. Each card represents a key insight, sourced and summarized, and we can see how they relate to each other. This is thinking with the eye, not just reading what it spits out. Okay, this looks nice, but we are a bit skeptical of information from unverified sources. So let's click on Search for Papers down here. This opens the academic search pane. We just copy our initial question or topic, paste it into the search box, and click the search icon. After some thinking, we get a list of academic papers. We can hover over each item to get an abstract of the full document, or click on it to open it in a new tab to check the details. Let's take this PDF file, Identifying Political Polarization in Social Media, a Literature Review, and add it to our mind map. This creates a new card. And now, because it is based on a PDF, we have slightly different options to interact with it. We can still add child or sibling cards manually, but if we click on Ask AI, we now have options to create a mind map based on the document only, without other web results, summarize the document, explain it, or get a conclusion. Let's go for the mind map option here. ResearchFlow now analyzes the PDF and adds cards based on the file's contents to our mind map. Depending on the file size, this can take a bit, but overall, it is really fast. We now have a new branch in our mind map with which we can interact in the same way as before. But what if we have our own papers that we want to include? Easy. We just click on the Upload PDF icon, navigate to the file or files on our PC, select one or multiple, and click Open. In this case, I selected two. Once they are uploaded, each file will get its own card on our mind map. Let's take the Impact of Social Media on Political Polarization. We can click on it and read the PDF right here. This looks interesting, so we go ahead and ask ResearchFlow to create a conclusion for this document. All we have to do is to click on Ask AI and Conclusion to get some child cards with the relevant information. As always, when working with any AI, we still need to think ourselves, verify and structure the information to fit our purpose though. We shall not blindly rely on this. The second PDF we uploaded is about social media and surveillance capitalism. As we are not very familiar with this particular aspect, we click Ask AI and Summarize to get a short explanation of the paper itself, its key themes, case studies, and conclusions. These key themes look interesting. We want to know more about those. ResearchFlow can help us here too. Again, we click Ask AI and then on Dive In. This gives us detailed explanations for each theme. Now, let's zoom out and take a look. Our mind map is fairly big by now, but our general information coming from the web is still separated from the academic data. Let's put those into context. To do so, we can simply drag a card or a whole branch of our mind map and drop it on any other card. And this is how we get from reading research to understanding it. Now for something fun, gaming. You might be familiar with a game called Age of Empires. Its first version was released in 1997, and I have been playing it since then, currently in the latest version called Age of Empires 2 Definitive Edition. Age of Empires is a real-time strategy game. As such, there are many different ways to succeed or fail. So let's research the best strategies in Age of Empires 2 based on skill level. If you have never heard of the game, that's totally fine. It is just a non-academic example to demonstrate how we can use ResearchFlow for such purposes too. We start the same way by asking a question. This time we will ask, what are the best strategies in Age of Empires 2 depending on a player's skill level from absolute beginner to professional? And yes, we search the web. Probably there won't be many academic papers on this topic. As before, we get a nice mind map starting from our question, structuring the results in relevant categories, in this case by skill level from beginner all the way down to professional. Let's stick with the beginner level for a moment. It says we should focus on basic economic management and initial military strategy. Well, that sounds good, but somewhat generic. Oh, here it says we shall learn basic unit counters. That seems like good advice. So we click on Ask AI. But instead of taking one of the predefined options, we ask our own question. Explain basic unit counters in Age of Empires 2. And again, after some thinking, we get a whole branch of cards with everything we need to know about the different unit types, such as infantry, ranged units, cavalry, siege, and so-called unique units. And even special counters are listed. For each type, we can see what they are good and weak against. Clearly, this isn't just for academics. It's a playground for curiosity and creativity too. Just imagine mapping out your next campaign for the role-playing game of your choice here, whether it's online or face-to-face, or on a more serious note, mapping out your business strategy. ResearchFlow can help with all of those without limiting our minds, but rather letting us explore and go in any direction we want. I'm not gonna lie, I like everything so far. But the next bit is my favorite part. It's about taking this mind map and put it into a useful format for further processing and documenting. And what is our favorite format? Exactly, Markdown. Okay, we have built our mind map. We got rid of irrelevant cards, arranged the branches as we want them, and are ready for the next step. Getting all this information into our Obsidian vault. For this, we have two simple options. First, we open the research report, then we click on Export, Save As, and then Markdown. There is also a PDF option. If you prefer that, you can use it, of course. If we stick with Markdown, then this will download the Markdown file, and we can then drag it into our vault. Alternatively, we can again click on Export, Copy As, and then on Markdown. This puts the whole text onto our clipboard, from where we can paste it into the node of our choice in Obsidian. As one would expect, the node renders as it should based on our theme and settings. It also keeps all the references to the sources, and I think that's pretty cool, ResearchFlow uses Mermaid to create charts, and even mathematical formulas are displayed very nicely. I mean, how cool is that? But we are not done yet. If we like the mind map, we can also export that one by clicking on Share, Export, select PNG, and click Export again. This formats the cards into more traditional mind map branches. That's really convenient for sending the mind map, but we cannot really interact with it at all. Fortunately, there's yet another export option. Let's click Share and Export again. But this time we choose Interactive HTML as our output format. Then we open a downloaded HTML file, and here we can zoom, navigate, collapse, and expand the branches as we wish. So, whether you want to get perfectly formatted Markdown notes for Obsidian, static pictures of your mind map, or an interactive version, ResearchFlow creates them all quickly and reliably. So, here is the bottom line. If you use Obsidian, if you do any kind of professional or private research or planning, if you're tired of jumping between tabs, tools, and scattered data all over the place, then ResearchFlow gives you a focused, visual, Markdown-friendly solution that works for superstructured thinkers just as well as for more creative but potentially less organized minds. You ask, it maps. You refine. Then you export everything in your way. I know what you're thinking. How can I get my hands on this? Well, you can head over to rflow.ai and sign up for the free plan called Casual. If you consider signing up for the paid Pro plan, you can use the link and code in the description to get a 20% discount and, at the same time, support my channel without any cost to you. If you do that, thank you so much. I really hope this will help you with your next research or planning endeavor. And if you like this video, share it with your friends. Perhaps drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring the notification bell to make sure you won't miss the next one. As always, let me know your thoughts and questions in the comments. The channel is still small enough for me to read and answer them all. And that's it for today. Oh, have you watched this video already? If not, check it out. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.